video session on PIC instruction set for byte oriented file register operations. Myself, Mr. Vipul Kondekar from Walchand of Technology, Solapur. The learning outcomes for this video session, student will be able to describe these different byte oriented operations and operation of instructions for addition, subtraction, then clearing the data, incrementing, decrementing, moving the contents. So these are the contents of this session where we will talk about what these byte oriented instructions are, and then we will see operation of these different instructions with reference to their syntax, what operands are required, what exact operation is carried out, which flag bits are affected, and then with one example we will try to understand these instructions. Now before starting instructions, what are the different byte oriented operations possible with the PIC microcontroller? So PIC supports operation for addition, subtraction, these are the arithmetic operations possible, logical operations like ANDing, inclusive OR and exclusive OR, these are the operations possible. It can complement the byte, clearing the contents, incrementing, decrementing, rotate and move, these type of operations are possible by using PIC microcontroller. Now when you talk about byte oriented operations, the opcode for that byte oriented operation will invoke two things. One will be the file register which you want to deal with, and D, which is the destination bit. If D is equal to 0, then whatever is the operation, the destination of that operation result will be available in the working register. If D bit is 1, then the destination is what? File register. And F can be a file register, that will be the 7-bit file register address. So you have to mention the file register. Prior to that, you have to make sure that the bank in which that particular file register is there, that has to be selected, because 7-bit address you are specifying in the instruction, 2 bits from the bank. So you can talk about total 9-bit address of the data memory location. Now, what is the difference between bit oriented and byte oriented instructions? Now talking about the bytes, now let us go for understanding different byte oriented operations, where we start with first arithmetic instruction, which is addition. Now what this instruction does, this instruction is used to add the contents of working register and file register. So file register can take value from 0 to 127, contents of working and destination D bit can belong to 0 or 1. Working register contents are added with the file register, and whatever is the result goes to the destination. What is the destination? If D bit is 0, destination is working register. If D bit is 1, then the destination is file register itself. Whenever you are doing addition, again the status register flag bits are there, carry flag, digit carry, which is analogous to the auxiliary carry flag of 8051 microcontroller, as well zero flag. So these are the flag bits affected because of this particular instruction. Let us try to understand with one example. If I take add WF FSR comma 0. So what you want? You want to add the contents of working register and FSR register. FSR has value C2, working register has value 17, C2 plus 17. So whatever is the result, where it gets stored? In the working register. So you find that C2 plus 17 hex, that results into D9. FSR value will be C2 as it is. So this is how I get the addition, and result here is available in the working register. Now if I consider another example, add WF INDF, here what you are doing, you are adding the contents of working register, but INDF is used in the instruction, means definitely it is an indirect addressing mode. So if working register contents are 70, FSR contents are C2, and contents of address of FSR are 20. So what addition is carried out here? Indirect addressing is used here, where the contents of working register are added with the contents of memory location pointed by FSR, and those are what we can say 20. So they are added, and whatever is the result is available where? In the file register, means the location which is pointed by FSR. So the contents of C2 are going to change. So this 17 plus 20, so that comes out to be 37. Where that 37 will go to the memory location pointed by that FSR register. This is how what we can say indirect addressing works. Now, like addition, you can have ANDing. This is the logical operation supported by the PIC microcontroller, where you can have bit by bit ANDing. So working register contents are ANDed with the file register, and whatever is the result, that goes to the destination. This ANDing operation affects the zero flag bit. So result of ANDing, if it is zero, then this zero flag bit will be set. Take one example, add AND WF FSR. So what it does, contents of working register 17 convert into binary, which is available here, and C2 are the contents of FSR. So bit by bit, 1 ANDed with 0, result is what? 0. 1 ANDed with 1, result is what? 1. So like this, you get the result as 02, and this 02 will be available in the destination. Here, you have not mentioned D bit, means you have not written 1 or 0 here. Default value of D is 1, indicating by default, the result is going to stored in the file register itself. So here you find the result is available in the file register. Now, another operation possible by using microcontroller is clear a particular file register. Many times whenever you are writing program, you are using some counters or some variables, and you want that these variables should be initialized with zero values. So this is a useful instruction. In that case, any file register contents can be cleared, or you may say initialized to zero. So 00 will go to the file register, and as the result is zero, that one goes to zero flag bit, means zero flag is affected whenever this instruction gets executed. This instruction is again single word, single cycle instruction. So if I take example CLRF flag register, before execution of this instruction, the contents of flag register are, let us say, 5A. After execution, what you are going to get is contents will become 00, as well zero flag is set after execution of this particular instruction. This is one more instruction available, complement. So complement is what? It's one's complement. So if bit is 1, it will become 0, 0 bit is there in the before execution, it becomes 1. So like this, all 8 bits of the file register are complemented. So contents of file register are complemented, and it goes to the destination. And again, if after complementing the contents, if the result is 0, then 0 flag is again affected. So this is how encoding will take place for the opcode. And again, single word, single cycle instruction. So before execution, after execution, if I take, you want to complement REG1 and store the result where 0 means working register itself. So 1 3 1 3 you convert into binary, then wherever you have 1, convert it to 0, wherever you have 0, convert it to 1, what you get? EC. So that EC value gets stored in the working register itself. This is how you can do the complement operation on any file register contained. Now, many times whenever you have counters or loop counters, you want to either increment or decrement that counter. So yes, this instruction is useful in that case, decrement file register. So decrementing file register is what? So that file register value gets decremented by 1 and result goes to the destination. And after decrementing, again, it is possible that the result is 0. So 0 flag is affected. Single word, single cycle instruction. Let us take one example for decrement. So what I am doing here, decrement file register. And which file register? File register, I have assigned name to that file register address as CNT. So CNT value you want to decrement. So before execution, the contents of that CNT file register are 01, and 0 flag is cleared. And then what happens after execution? So this CNT value will get decremented by 1. 1 decremented by 1 will be what? 0. And as the result is 0, 0 flag will be set because of execution of this particular instruction. This is one more instruction for decrement, where you are taking the decision about skipping the next instruction. Decrement file and skip if 0. Let us try to understand what this instruction does. So this instruction decrements the file register by 1, and it stores it to the destination, and if the result is zero after decrementing, what it does is it skips the execution of the next immediate instruction. If the result is not zero, then sequential execution will be carried out. So next instruction will get executed. So decision about whether to skip or not, it depends on whether the result is zero or not after decrementing. You'll understand it better with one example. Here I am executing decrement and skip if zero, count whatever is the result after decrementing, I want to store in the file register itself, and then go to loop. Let us take one example where before execution the PC value is address of here, means next instruction which gets executed will be this particular instruction, and CNT value is 01. So before execution this is 01, so after execution of the instruction it becomes 0. And if the result is 0, what you are going to do is you are going to skip the next instruction, means when you are executing this, this instruction will get skipped. So in that case, what will be PC? PC will go to the address of the continue, so means the PC will change to the instruction whose address is continue as a label. Now again, before execution, suppose the contents are 02, so if you decrement it becomes 01, so it's not 0, so that will be sequential execution. So which instruction gets executed? Address of here plus 1. So this is how you are deciding whether to skip the next instruction or not based on the result what you get after decrementing a particular file register. Like that, you can have increment in the file register. Decrement is subtraction by 1, so increment is addition by 1. So if count value has FF, if I increment it by 1, FF incremented by 1 will be result into 0, and as the result is 0, 0 flag will be set. Like that, you can have instruction increment again file register and skip if 0. So again, after incrementing, it is possible that result is 0. For example, if the contents are FF before execution, and if I increment it, what it becomes? 00. And if the result is 0, what you are going to do is you are going to skip the execution of the next instruction. So PC here also will change to the address of continue, means this particular instruction gets skipped when the result is 0. And if the result is non-zero before execution, if the value is 00 itself, if I increment it, it is going to become 01. So where it goes? It will goes to for the sequential execution. So next instruction will get executed. So now next instruction is for moving the contents. So MOVF. So MOVF, what it does? The contents of file register goes to destination. So if DBT is 0, you can understand that file register will go to the working register. But interestingly, if DBT is 1, what is going to happen? The contents of file register will go to the destination, and destination is file register itself. You might be thinking, what is the use of this instruction? So file register contents are moved to the file register itself. But you can find this is one interesting thing, that this can affect the zero flag. So whenever you are moving the file register contents, you can check if those contents are zero or not. Means if zero flag is set, then you can say that that particular file register contents are zero. So this can be used for checking whether the file register contents are zero or not. So this is MOVF instruction. And on the same line, there is one more instruction, MOVWF, where you can move the contents of working register to the file register. So working register contents are copied to the file register. So before execution, if I take one example, MOVWF, option register is FF, working register is 4F. So what it does? The contents of working register are moved to the file register. So hence, working register contents are written as it is, but file register contents becomes 4F. So this is how this MOVF instruction works. So these are the few byte-oriented instructions we have seen in this video session. These are the references used for this particular video session. Thank you.